Hi, I'm Justin Fraction, and I'm here today to present to you a sweet piece of software that will help you securely share files that are too large for email for a serious alternative to cloud backup and storage services products like Google Drive or Dropbox. You might want to try SugarSync. And as always, if you're just getting started on your search, we can help. Visit our website at technologyadvice.com to get a free list of cloud backup and storage software recommendations. Click the annotation in the top right corner of your screen to get started. And if you find this video helpful, please feel free to like, comment, and subscribe. SugarSync is an incredibly simple software offering file syncing between multiple devices and multiple platforms from multiple folders. Once you install SugarSync, you'll get a window that will show you what files are securely stored in the cloud, which files you are sharing, what the current activity is on each file, and a search function to find files. As some users have mentioned, the UI is a bit outdated, but it gets the job done. If you want to add a folder to synchronize to the cloud, you simply click on the folder and drag it onto the SugarSync window where indicated. The device filter drop-down at the top right side of the screen will tell you which computer houses the original file. And if you go to your file finder on whatever device you choose to use, you can see a collection of all of the files stored in the cloud. You can also see files that are shared with you by other people by going to the sharing menu, and yes, all this sounds a lot like Google Drive, so the mechanics of this should be familiar to most people. There is also a way to share files with your contacts list, or if you're sending pictures, for example, see a thumbnail of every photo. I knew from the start this video would come down to me explaining how the software is different from Google Drive or Dropbox or any of the other multiple cloud services out there. Well, luckily, SugarSync has heard all this before, and they have a couple of charts on their website which will detail exactly how they're different and why it's a viable alternative to Google Drive. I'm gonna throw out the script for a little bit and talk to you directly here. So why are we covering SugarSync? Well, variety is the spice of life. With any industry, we don't want one company that handles all aspects of it. We feel the same way with software as well. We don't want one software package that everyone has to use because it's the only one that serves that function. We don't want just Google Drive, we want Dropbox, and we also want Box. We want people to have the choice to choose what they want to use to securely store their files and share them between computers. SugarSync has been around for a very long time. It was around even before Google Drive, I believe, and it's still here. And in tech, that says a lot, because things that are great, they might have been great at the time they came out, but a few decades later, maybe not so much, or maybe people have moved on, or maybe they can't continue to finance their particular company, so they disappear. But with this particular product, it's been around for so long that there has to be something to it that makes it great. I think many people look at it and they say, okay, the UI is a bit outdated, but it does exactly what it's supposed to do. Also, I think it's a good thing that the software hasn't changed that much over the past few years. Why? Because people get used to things. And there have been so many companies that have so many online cloud-based platforms and even actual pieces of software that you must download to your desktop, where you look at them one day and they look one way, and then you look about a month later and they've changed something. And they continually see this as innovation, which is good. But it doesn't really help when I want to get something done if I don't know where a button is, or where a certain menu setting is, or where something has moved to when I just remember this morning it was somewhere else. Sometimes keeping things the same is good because people get used to them and they can focus more on getting their work done and less on Googling where a menu option is. SugarSync is a pay program, but it's also one that you know people are going to be keeping an eye on, because if you ever have an issue with it, since the company isn't as big as, say, Google, you can contact them directly and get help. You're paying for that. That's good. Let's check out one more thing. They have this Q&A here explaining why you use SugarSync over any other service. One of the things that stands out here is multi-folder syncing. So you can have this application only sync files to certain computers that you also have SugarSync on. SugarSync comes with a 30-day free trial, which is one user issue because many other applications have at least a free version. The other user issue is that people believe that the personal and business plans are kind of expensive for what SugarSync does when there are other options that are cheaper. However, SugarSync is a good cloud backup solution, even if there are other alternatives out there. At the end of the day, it all comes down to personal preference, and SugarSync is a viable option. People that currently use it have used it for years, and they love it. So maybe they're afraid of change, or maybe they're onto something. It's a good idea to get multiple quotes before choosing a cloud backup and storage solution. If you're interested in SugarSync, you might also want to consider Google Drive, Dropbox, Microsoft OneDrive, and Box. Still not sure if SugarSync is right for you? Visit our website at technologyadvice.com for our free list of the best cloud backup and storage service options available today. Click on the button on the left to get started.